Okay, selamat tengah hari, kelas, and afternoon. Okay, we'd like to start today's lectures with another example where it is statically indeterminate, but it involves the structures where the type of members, the type of structural members, the characteristics, they are different. One example is a cable suspended cantilever beam. So this can be seen, for example, in the roof structures. When you have a cantilever, so normally for the roof, you don't want to have any column here, but when it is, depending on the situations, this deflection might be too high, so you put a cable to pull it back, especially if the span here, the free span, is too long. So this is one example where we have a type of structures which we call composite, because you have cable and beam. Okay? Cable and beam, or truss and beam, so the characteristics of cable and characteristics of beams, they are different. Beam is mainly bending. If you apply load, it carries load because of bending, and cable, it carries load because of the axial actions. So in cable, mainly we have only tension and compression. Cable cannot take any bending, and beam, we have bending and also we have axial deformations. So this is a problem given here. We have a composite structure. So the question is, determine the tension in this cable BD. Use method of least work. So these are the explanation about the problem. 1.8 meter high between A and D, 2.5 meter from A to B, B to C is 1.5, and there's a concentrated load 65, and there is a cable here connecting to the beam at point B and then suspended from point D. And in for cable, the cross-sectional area is given as 500 millimeter square. And for beam, there are two values given for the section properties: cross-sectional area for beam and moment inertia. This is the second moment area, which is important for bending. And cross-sectional area that is important for axial deformations. So whenever we have cable, this A, the cross-sectional area, must be given. For beam, both should be given. If cross-sectional area is not given, then we do not have to consider axial deformations. So we want to see how you apply method of least work. So the first thing is, if you have to check this is statically indeterminate and what is the degree of statical indeterminacy. So to do that, you just compare how many unknown forces. So we make use of this free body diagram. You have this free body diagram showing the beam. So how many forces acting on the beam? This is a fixed support, so 1, 2, 3, and as a cable connecting to point B, so you have also the cable force, which I use the red color to indicate that cable force. So unknown force, there are four. Equilibrium equation, there are only three. So this is obviously statically indeterminate. And the degree of statical indeterminacy is 4 minus 3, you get 1. And because next you choose the redundant that you want to solve, you determine which redundant that you want to choose as a redundant. You can choose the moment here, you can choose the vertical reaction here, you can also choose the horizontal reaction force. You can also choose the cable. Any one of these you can choose as a redundant, then you solve for the redundant first. Here we choose this cable force because the question asks us to find cable force. Yeah, determine tension in cable BD. So if you choose the cable force directly as a redundant, then you solve, you get directly the cable tension. If not, you can choose this moment as your redundant. After that, you have to use equilibrium equation to find what is this tension force. So because we are asked to find tension in cable, so we choose directly, this is as the redundant. So what we do next is, you apply this tension force. So the second is, you choose tension in cable as redundant force. So this is the redundant force. And this cable will be applied on the beam example and together with other load here, and we use method of least work. Here, because of you have cable and beam here, so the strain energy stored in these composite structures, there are two types. One is because the cable become longer and shorter, this cable will be pulled. So you have strain energy stored, which is due to axial deformations. And for beam, because there's a load here, the beam will bend, so you have bending deformation in beam. And you have also, because you have a cable pulling, so this part of the beam will be in compression. Okay, imagine this part will be in compression, so you have axial deformations. So there are two types of strain energy involved. One is axial deformation, the other one is bending deformations. This one comes from here, and also this part of the beam, and this one comes from the beam. So this cable does not contribute anything to strain energy due to bending, because cable, we do not consider cable to take bending. In analysis, we consider cable cannot take bending. So the strain energy that we need to consider is these two parts. Summation of this is strain energy due to axial deformation, strain energy due to bending deformation. And principle of least work says that del u del t, the redundant, must be equal to zero. So the equation that we need to solve is this equation. Is this equation. So del f del t, you know, we differentiate this partially respect to t, this is what we get. Differentiate this respect to t, this is what we get. So this is similar to the equation that you use when you solve a beam problem or a frame problem later on when we look at one. And this is similar to the equation that you use when you solve a thrust problem. So there are two parts here in this composite structures. So we know that we have to find the axial, we have to find the, this is an axial force, F is axial force in the members, M is a bending moment. So we have to find the axial force in members DB, which is cable, and in also part AB of this beam here. Part BC, from this free body diagram, we know that BC, there is no axial force. And we have to find bending moment for this beam A and B, B and C. Then differentiate respect to T, multiply with M, EI integrate, differentiate respect to T, multiply with the axial force, multiply with the length, divided by AE, make them equal to zero, and you find T. So this is the problem that we need to consider to find the axial force and to find bending moment in beam. And in cable, we have this tension T as the axial force. So because we have to find bending moment, so we have to choose, divide them into how many times you have to evaluate the bending moment. So you have to evaluate two times, A, B, and B, C. So the origin of X starting from C for B, C, and also starting from C for part A, B. So, and to find axial force, we resolve this, you resolve this tension force which is acting in this direction into horizontal component and vertical component. You resolve this into these two components, and we use this to find what is the axial force here, and this one will cause bending. This vertical component will cause bending, and this will cause axial force in part AB. So we have to evaluate F, we have to evaluate M. So the result is given in this table. So in the table, you have beam part and the cable part. And this is a composite, beam part, cable part. Then the beam divide into two segments because the bending moment changes, CB and BA, and this is the X coordinate system that we choose for integrations. We choose from origin C, and this is for CB, it varies from 0 to 1.5. Same origin C, but this is for BA, so the limit changes from 1.5 to 4. Bending moment, so you have to evaluate this, cut through a section between C and B, and use free body diagram, we get negative 65x. For this part, we get negative 65x plus, this is a vertical component of the cable force multiplied with x minus 1.5, axial force. Okay? Axial force, we have axial force, and go back this one. In the beam, you can calculate axial force here and here, but from B and C, this free body diagram, we see that BC, there is no axial force. You can confirm this if you cut this, make use of this free body diagram, then you see there is no axial force. But from B to A, because of this component, so this B and A will be compressed. So you have that axial force. For cable, the axial force is equal to the tension force, equal to the tension force T. So that's why in this table you have axial force for part BC, zero. This is for the beam. For part AB, compression, we get negative 0.8 T. For cable, the axial force is directly the cable tension T. So we have M, we have F, next we differentiate partially respect to T. There is no T here, so zero. So this one you get 0.6 x minus 1.5, and here because cable we do not consider bending, so there is no bending component. And next del F del T, so there is no T here, so zero. So del F del T you get negative 0.8, then del F del T because, so you get here 1. So this column and this and also the length. We need also the length. So finally, you substitute this value here from the table, multiply with F, and you have to find the length. The length of each of segment divided by AE plus, and then this is the part of the beam. So you substitute here, del M del T multiplied with M, and don't forget the EI. EI is constant. EI, so we can substitute here and do the integrations. You substitute there and do the integrations. So take out the E because E is constant. Yeah, E you can take out. Only A will be need to be used here. This is A for the beam, this is A for the cable part. And this one is, you need to do integration, substitute the value of this, and then integrate. And finally, you get the answer. Make them equal to zero, then you get an equation where you can find T. And you solve for T, this is a redundant force that we consider, you get 131.478 kilonewton. It's positive. So you get positive value means it is tension. It's correct. It should be tension. And the cable can only take tension force. So we assume tension, and finally you should get positive value. And the value T is 131.478. Okay? So the question only asks for cable force, so we stop here. If you need any, the reaction at A is required, and they can be determined by using equilibrium equations. You have reaction, you have three reactions at support A, so you use three equilibrium equations, then you can get AX, AY, and the moment reaction at support A. This question, these are not asked. These are not asked, so only stop here. If you ask to find reaction for the whole beam, for the whole composite cable and beam, so you must use equilibrium equation to find reaction at A after you have found this. Okay. So if you recall the basic procedures, they are the same. Okay. You identify the degree of statical indeterminacy. This is one here. You choose one redundant, then you determine what kind of strain energy expression that you have to use. Is it the beam problem? Is it the frame problem? Or is it the truss problem? Here, it combined. It combined a kind of truss problem and beam problem. So you have two strain energy, axial deformation and bending deformations. As a result, you have to use this, you have to solve these equations to get T. So you use the free body diagram to find the F, the axial force in each part of the members of the structures. Then you find the bending moment, then you do the partial differentiation. And you use table to help you so that you can find the necessary equation for you to use. You substitute this, and finally you get the answer. It is basically the same when we look at the truss problem or beam problems. Here it combines two strain energy, one due to axial deformation, the other one due to bending. Then if you need other reaction forces, then you have to use equilibrium equations. So there is an exercise here asking you to determine the tension of cable if axial deformation of beam is neglected. So you do not need to consider axial force or the deformation or the strain energy due to axial deformation in beam. We know that there will be axial force here. This part of the beam will become shorter. But the question asks you, there's no need to consider that strain energy due to axial deformation in beam. So the same procedures apply, okay? And then we have IB is equal to, and IB, this is a cross-sectional area of the moment inertia only. Here, cross-sectional area is given. So we have to consider axial deformations. In the exercise, this is not given. So there's no need to consider axial deformations. There's a loading here, 65. Okay, so if you repeat the solution process, there's no need to consider this part. No need to consider F for beam, there's no need to consider. Only consider F, axial deformation in cable only, and then see what is the difference in the answer. Okay. There's something wrong with this. Something wrong with this example. What's wrong with this? Can you solve this? There's a cable here. Then there's a beam here. This height is given. Everything given. Cable cross-sectional area already given. Inertia IB already given. A is not given because you don't have to. You're already asked to neglect the axial deformation in beam. So you don't need the information about cross-sectional area of the beam. Okay? So what is missing here? Yes, there is no load. This is a trick question. Trick. If there's no load, then the cable here, of course, there's no cable, no tension. Of course, the beam, you have self-weight. If you assume that there's a beam, there's no weight, and then there's no load, so this one cannot solve. So the load here, there should be a load which is the same as 65 kilonewton applied here. Okay? So please apply the load here, 65 kilonewton. And if you solve this, following the same procedures, there's only the axial deformation for beam, no need to consider. Then you can find the answer for cable force as 133.046. This is if you do not consider axial deformation in beam. So this answer compared with this answer, this is slightly larger. This is slightly smaller, that one slightly larger. The percentage difference is not that large. This one, you consider axial deformation, you get about 131. If you do not consider, you get about 133, which the difference is not large. So try this out. Just remember there is a 65 kilonewton here. Okay? There's a 65 kilonewton being applied there at point C. Without that load, I think there is no tension in the cable. Now I have distributed one page for you to look at. I give you one page of that I just now distribute for you to check. So there are only two questions here, just to help you to refresh what you are supposed to know and what you have, what we have gone through. Okay? If you look at that page, question number one says that method of least work, it uses this principle of least work. Okay, principle of least work. This is last week lectures and week before last. Last two lectures we have mentioned about principle of least work. So this question asks you to, there is an equation representing principle of least work. What is that equation? Write down that equation. The equation representing principle of least work. Principle of least work. Principle of least work is the principle that you use in method of least work. Okay, there's a definition for principle of least work. And what is the equation that you use to represent that principle? So the equation should be, I think, we have been using that equation in solving problems. So that equation is the principle of least work. We have this one equal, what is that? This one zero, this one? Del, this one del, to that? This one del u, this one del? Del R or del P or del anything. So R is the redundant. Very good. U is? U? Strain energy. Yes, very good. Full of energy. Strain energy is U, so redundant is R. So this is equation representing principle of least work. Okay. Then, what equation do you use next? It depends on whether you are solving a thrust problem, or you are solving a beam problem, or you are solving a frame problems. If you solve a thrust problem, so this is answer required. So using you are solving a thrust problem, then you have summation del equal zero. Del what? Del F, del R, this one. FLAE. If you are solving a beam or frame problems without considering axial deformations, then you are having summation integrations del M del R M over EI dx equals zero. So the basic one is this. Then depending you are solving a thrust problem, you are solving a beam problem or frame problems where you do not need to consider axial deformations, then you use this one. If you have to consider axial deformation, then you have to add. If for beam and frame, if you have to consider axial deformation, you have to add summation del F del R FL over AE equal to zero. This one you have to add to this if you are asked to consider axial deformations. So this is actually similar to this. So thrust, the characteristic of thrust is the member become longer and shorter, axial deformations. Now we look at the next questions, which is, this is just a very simple one, just to try to refresh yourself whether you know how to solve this using method of least work. So What is the first thing that you do? What is the first thing that you do? How many redundant you have to solve? Only one. So degree of statistical determinacy is one only. Okay? So you are asked to find the reaction force at roller support B. So redundant, what redundant you are going to choose? BY, because you are asked to find reaction force. So you have 1, 2, 3, this is A, this is B, this is BY. Okay? Then the next thing that you do is, what do you do? You have to find the, because this is a strain energy, this is the equation that you have to solve. And you have this as del M del BY, M over EI, dx equal to zero, right? So you have to find bending moment. So now when you are evaluating bending moment, I think if you know which one, if you cut and then which free body diagram that you use, then you can save some time. So let's say we have to cut here only once. Okay, this is the x there. Cut here only once. So this is the distributed W. Bending moment. We need only bending moment, so there's no need to indicate the shear force. You can forget about the shear force because you no need to have a. Okay. So this is a free body diagram that we need. So you get your bending moment equal to BYX minus WX square over 2. Then what do you need? You need del M del BY, which is del M del BY is equal to del M del BY. This, be careful, you differentiate with respect to redundant, yeah? Not respect to X or not respect to Y. So this one becomes X only. So finally, next one is, what you do, you just substitute that into this. So you substitute that. Here, we only need to evaluate bending moment once because the bending moment is the same for the whole length here. So you substitute there, integrate from 0 to L. EI, you can take out 1 over EI. Then you have del M del BY. Del M del BY is X. M is BYX minus WX square over 2 dx equal to 0. So finally, what is BY? Yeah, WL 3 over 8. And this is positive, so meaning that so this is the steps that you go through, and this is a very simple statically indeterminate beam, and you have to evaluate bending moment. You have to differentiate partially. Remember, differentiate partially with respect to redundant. Don't differentiate partially respect to X or respect to other things. Okay. So this is every. I expect everyone should be able to get it. There's no need for you to submit but I want you to just you make sure that you know how to solve this. You can get WL over 3 over 8 multiplied with WL. Okay. So not yet. We have to talk slowly. Okay. There's one small part. when you evaluate bending moment, if you choose this one, then you evaluate very fast. You can also evaluate like this, but then you have to consider all this here. This AY, AX we know is zero, MA. Okay. So if you choose BY as your redundant, then when you evaluate bending moment, if you evaluate bending moment, you use this part, then the solution process is shorter. If you use this part, you can also use this part, but then you have to find AY in terms of BY first, MA in terms of BY, AX we know is zero, then find the bending moment M in terms of BY, then do the same thing. So when you, because finding bending moment is one of the very time-consuming part in this analysis method. So be sure you know how to find bending moment, how many times you have to cut, and choose the correct free body diagram that makes the calculations shorter. No need to evaluate reaction force here, because you are not asked to find this. You are only asked to find this. Okay, so familiar yourself with how to get bending moment and also which free body diagram when you cut, which part to use. You choose the part which safe to make the calculation shorter. Okay? So that's it for today, and then I'll see you again.